I welcome you students to a discussion on elements of group 16. Here I would like to explain the concepts which you should know to give reason for some specific behavior of these elements and the compounds. Elements of group 16, as you know, are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. As you all know, the first member of the group exhibits anomalous behavior. Anomalous means strange behavior, or it behaves in a way different from the rest of the group members. That is because of three things about the first element. You should be knowing this: small size, high electronegativity, and absence of d orbitals. Now, for many of the properties of oxygen and its compounds, you can give reason from any one of these properties of oxygen. One of these will be responsible for that specific behavior of oxygen and its compounds. Let me straight away go to the statements for which you will have to give reason. The question is, account for the following. The first one, group 15 elements have higher first ionization enthalpy than group 16 elements. You know, as you move from left to right along a period, ionization enthalpy increases. So we expect group 16 elements to have higher first ionization enthalpy than group 15. But as given in the statement, group 15 elements only have higher first ionization enthalpy. The reason for that is the electronic configuration. Group 15 elements have the electronic configuration NS2NP3, which is a half-filled state of p level. This leads to greater stability. Hence, to remove one electron from this configuration requires more energy than what is required to remove the fourth electron in the NS2NP4 configuration of group 16 elements. I suppose it is clear to you. Let me pass on to the next one. Oxygen is a gas while other elements of the group are solids. If you had listened to my video on group 15, you should be knowing the answer, because the explanation is the same as we did for the question. Nitrogen is a gas while other elements of the group are solids. Here it is oxygen. But the reason is the same. Oxygen, being a small element, forms p pi bond. It can use its p orbitals to form pi bond, so we call it p pi bond, and it exists as O double bond O, and so that is one part of it. The other part of it is, in between the O2 molecules, the van der Waals forces are very weak. Actually, strong intermolecular forces make the molecules come closer. And when they come closer, they exist as liquids and then solids also. So it is the intermolecular forces which are deciding the physical state of the substance. O2 molecules have very weak intermolecular forces. So these are the two parts of the answer. Then, oxygen exhibits only -2 oxidation state, while other members exhibit +2, +4 and +6 states also. Oxygen, being highly electronegative, readily accepts 2 electrons to exhibit -2 oxidation state, except in peroxides, in which it exhibits -1 oxidation state. And what is the reason for not exhibiting +2, +4 and +6 states by oxygen? You should be knowing that it is due to the absence of d orbitals. The last one in the set is, sulfur in vapor state exhibits paramagnetism. Sulfur in vapor state exists partly as S2. S2 in vapor state like O2 has two unpaired electrons in its pi star 2px and pi star 2py orbitals. If you recall what you learnt in molecular orbital theory, O2 molecules paramagnetic behavior also is explained by the presence of unpaired electrons in pi star 2px and pi star 2py orbitals. It's the same case with sulfur also. What I explained to you, I have presented here as answers that should be written as reason for the statements I had already given to you. So this should make your learning easier for you. You have a few more statements here for which you have to give suitable reason. H2O is a liquid while other hydrates of the group are gases. By now you should be familiar with the fact that the reason must be hydrogen bonding. When hydrogen bonds are present, the molecules are drawn closer, so it will exist in the liquid state. Oxygen is quite electronegative, so hydrogen bonds are present in H2O. But it is not the case with other elements of the group. They are not electronegative enough, so there are no hydrogen bonds in them, in those hydrates, and so those are gases. H2S is acidic while H2O is neutral. Or you can also say water is neutral while the acidic nature of the hydrate increases as we go down the group. Here the reason is size of the atom. Since sulfur is a larger atom, the SH bond is weaker. So the bond breaks readily, making the hydrogen available to exhibit acidic character. So as the size of the atom increases as we go down, the bond between the element and hydrogen breaks readily, which makes it more acidic. SF6 is not readily hydrolyzed. You know the hybridization of sulfur in SF6 is sp3d2. It has an octahedral shape and it is completely spherically protected. So for hydrolysis, the water molecule has to make an attack on the sulfur atom, which is not possible. And also fluorine does not have any d orbital. So that explains why SF6 is not readily hydrolyzed. You have to use a silent electric discharge in the preparation of ozone. You know, ozone is an endothermic compound. If there is no silent electric discharge, that means if there is a flash, it will decompose to form oxygen. Then high concentration of ozone is explosive. Ozone can readily decompose to oxygen, and that change O3 to O2 has high negative value for delta H. That is, it is a highly exothermic reaction. Del H for that change has high negative value. So high concentration of ozone will be explosive. So now I will give the correct reason in statements. You can read that. You can go through the answers given here and learn them. You see, I have taken up only one type of questions here for discussion in this session. Give reason for the following statements or account for the following. So for that type of question only, I have explained and I have done the discussion. So it's mainly with regard to group 16 elements. You have learnt reasons for certain specific properties of the elements and the compounds. Thank you.